So welcome all. My name is Hakan, Hakan Lukadiroğlu. I am a project coordinator of Sport for Solidarity. Actually, why we have chosen this name? Because as a magical tool, sport makes things happen that would usually impossible. We have been carrying out our project since 2019, and we have seen very quick responses on the at the field. That's why I would like to share my experiences from the field of this project. This project has been carrying out in 7 big cities of Turkey, which is if we calculate whole population of these 7 countries, it is much more crowded than many European countries. And when we look at the refugees and the numbers of refugees in each cities of Turkey, it can easily create some kind of social unrest in different cities of Turkey. And we see that if we are implying this sport-related projects in our cities, it means it heals the wounds and it uneases our social unrest in different cities. So, there is a famous saying, time heals the wounds. We believe that, yes, time heals wounds, but we cannot say time is alone to heal the wounds. That's why it needs some kind of companions to heal the wounds. So one of the best companions of time is support. Regarding this perspective, we are implementing this project. We are just using support as a magical tool to heal the wounds within a shorter time. As an educator, I see that education is costly and it takes time, but support is one of the best shortcuts to reach into goals, especially for refugees and host communities. So my country, we define our country, it's in the middle of our world. That's why it's too attractive for many displaced people and coming from different corners of our world to our country. Right now, due to geostrategic location, we are hosting more than, this is actually an official number, but we can easily say that we are hosting more than 4 billion displaced people in Turkey in different titles, such as displaced or forced displaced or international protection and so on. So that's why we need to deal with this huge population coming from different backgrounds in our lovely country. So this project is being carried under the Ministry of Youth and Sport, and Ministry of Youth and Sport has a huge resources and capabilities to imply this project. And of course, serving all young people of Turkey, but also hosting many sports facilities, holding many sports facilities in Turkey as well. Right now, over 850,000 students are staying at the dormitories of Ministry of Youth and Sport. That's why we can easily get access to a huge number of students, in especially these are university students. We can easily get access to these universities. And also the ministry is holding several youth camps, youth centers, and support halls, stadiums as well. And the ministry is trying to use its resources and capabilities as much as possible, and we are sharing these capabilities and resources with refugees as well, not only limited with our citizens of Turkey. Here is our project in Turkey, Support for Solidarity project. And it's a really a good example of collaboration to share the burdens of international organizations, NGOs, and public institutions, because it is supported by ORF, Olympic Refugee Foundation, and with the help of with the generous support of ORF, we are carrying out this effective project in Turkey. It covers seven biggest cities of Turkey. Look at these cities. Istanbul is over 15 million population, one of the biggest cities, not only in Turkey, but also in our world. And the other cities are also the biggest cities of Turkey. It means with the help of this project, we can get access to almost two out of three population of whole country. And the project now is in the second phase of the implementation. And there are 20 different nationalities attending this project, and we are also offering different branches, and till now we have covered 21 different courses for attendees, beneficiaries. Besides support courses, because right now it's last 6 months, each period lasts 6 months. Besides this period, we are also doing sports festival, camping events, awareness raising activities for beneficiaries. And of course, we are also giving a soul of Olympic spirit to attendees as well. With the help of this project, we can also get access to kids, especially regarding their protection. We have just published a booklet, Support for Protection booklet, according to UNHCR and IOC guidelines. I think in a nutshell, I would like to say yes, we would like to say thank you for all companions during our challenging journey. And we are really eager to make more collaboration in international organizations, NGOs, and other relevant partners to imply more project for our refugees and for the population. Thank you.